Welcome to this week's update. We are all crammed up here because we got our friends back from y'all Texas.
Yeah, look, straight out of Texas.
Straight out of Texas and
where'd you go?
Oregon.
Austin?
Austin.
Can I just tell you something about Austin, Texas? It's the most liberal town in the entire state of Texas.
You can tell. You just look at the paintings that they make and the words they write on it.
So you decided you'd go to Texas and go to the most liberal city.
Actually, we stayed
in
Leander. It was about 30 minutes from Austin.
We also live in... very liberal.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah, this is
it
worse.
We went from Austin, Texas
worse?
To...
What's wrong with that?
This is what...
I wasn't saying it was bad.
I meant...
noticing the choice you made.
Yeah, it's not worse. It's worse.
Yeah, that's where our family is.
Yeah.
You gotta go where you go.
Because my sister's weird.
I don't know. She needs Jesus for sure.
No, I liked it.
What
Texas
was
good.
Can we start this over?
Oh, okay.
Right,
I really
want
to use
cut.
It.
Do you know how to use it?
Crossfire update, scene 461. Take four,
You thought you did something.
Scene update, wait. Oh, we didn't start?
You might have,
wait. Oh, he's starting over now. That's
he was rolling with us.
Quite on set.
What happens when you do this? See, if there's a noise in here and it triggers our camera, right? So you go, we gotta start over because of Christy once again.
Quiet on set.
You know what?
Go ahead, Christy,
you're about to trigger me.
Quiet on set, ready, action.
But it turned off. It didn't turn on.
Oh, baby.
That's true.
Oh, guys.
It's on. You're
that's so funny.
Yeah, we're done. Right. You're triggered me.
Ew.
I'm just kidding. Triggered.
Hey, we're here with you for an update. We wanted to give you a minute to log on.
Yeah.
And
do you feel updated?
They haven't gotten anything yet.
Well, they're here for the update. Do you feel updated?
I don't know. Okay, we want to start by telling you these two cannot tell us anything about the car show or the lake day.
Or the motorcycle.
Actually, I watched a live stream.
All I can say is my car was there. And I won no trophies. But that's okay. I'm happy with
that. My motorcycle was there.
My motorcycle was there and I won no trophies also.
You know what?
There was some big bad boys here with some crazy cars and motorcycles.
Oh yeah, there were some crazy cars and motorcycles.
And girls.
Yeah.
If we were here, babe, you would have won because I would have made sure everyone voted for you.
So you're saying you would have just stuffed the ballot box?
The fix would have been in.
Yeah,
I would
have. Hey, don't be talking like that. We don't cheat.
Hey, look, everyone's right.
It was a fair.
I wouldn't have done that.
There it is. That's us riding in. Hey, there I am.
No, that's me.
That's us riding. We just look alike. Riding in to the church. Yeah.
That's cool.
That was fun. There's the car show. Look at that. Yeah.
Nice 55 Chevy.
55 Chevy. Who's that belong to?
My grandpa Rich.
Look at there. There's the van.
Pete's that beautiful Mustang.
That's sale. A van for sale. I want to buy it.
It was a van once. Now it's a van again.
I'm going to sleep in it.
It's the most beautiful blue.
You can see amazing.
The most beautiful blue
right
ever.
Left.
Oh, you saw his left front tire.
You could see Caleb's.
Dude, it was numbers.
Tire.
I don't know. I give
it was really
numbers.
Cool. I don't know who it was.
What was really awesome is the amount of people who came and was there.
There's lots of people there.
And that were unchurched. I mean, there was a predominantly unchurched group of people. This was a really awesome outreach. That's the one thing I can say that I appreciate. So
Al Gaines was like, what's happening? Because it kept restarting. That was
a big joke.
Restarting
because it was a joke.
When we did this, Al, it would restart automatic. Because of the noise.
Not that time.
Maybe
not.
You did it again right there.
It's broken. It's not. It's
you broke it. Hey, take your thing back. It broke.
It's broken. Good.
It is now.
Uh-oh.
Here we go.
Steve,
come on.
Cue the camera.
Broken.
Steve's broken. All right. So the motorcycle day was great. We had a number of people who gave their heart to
Motor
the Lord.
Fest.
Motorfest.
That's what it was called.
And this is the announcement that is so important. Mm-hmm. Next year,
we're doing it again
on Labor Day Sunday, the Sunday of Labor Day.
Yep.
We are doing another Motorfest.
Motorfest, second annual
mm-hmm. Motorfest, and we're gonna
do
bikes.
Giveaways. We had shirts. We had gift cards. We had
pretty awesome. Who made the shirts?
Some really awesome lady.
I know she was awesome.
So, they turned out good too.
Yeah, the shirts turned out great. Yeah. So next year we will be doing the same thing. We're adding power sports and four-wheel drives. So we only
and
had
we'll
one
advertise
line.
More better.
And we'll advertise more better. No one
September 3rd.
September 3rd, 2023. And we always say this, Lord willing. Why do we say Lord willing?
Because he could come back.
Oh, we could come back.
Part of the Holy Spirit.
But it was so... I was zoning out. Can we just say how awesome it was? There was a sea of people here.
Yeah.
It was awesome. We had a great barbecue. I wouldn't really know because I didn't eat any of it.
I had
a dog. It was great.
I walked up and picked a dog up and ate it as I ran. It was crazy.
A hot dog or a real
dog? Like, it, you should have heard
it barking.
Warm.
Was
barking
with it.
As he's
yelping.
You always eat them tail first so they make noise right to the end.
Gross.
Nasty.
That's weird. Anyway.
I'm weird too.
Well, whatever. And then.
I love you, babe.
Then the next day on Labor Day, we went to the lake. We had a lake day.
Yeah, look at that. I bet there's a picture of the lake day.
We had some lake day stuff.
There's Anthony at the lake.
We rode a boat.
Yep.
Boat, we had ski two people. Boats. You know what's funny?
No, that's
Casey.
That's a lie. We
look
did
there's
not
those.
Ski anybody. We
no,
tubed people.
But did you know that Casey has never went on an inner tube or a ski ever? Until this day.
Until this day. And you and drug his bum behind
I
that boat.
I drug his...
And it was...
I don't think we have any boat pictures.
You should. You
no.
Might.
Maybe. There!
It was really... It was fun. We had kayaks. We had fun.
Why is Steve...
Because those are the ones
showing
got
all
from
the
his
pictures
wife.
Of his wife.
Because that's the ones that he was able
like,
to get.
I love her. I want to have... No, it was great. We had such great time.
That's awesome.
Yeah. So it was fantastic. We're going to do that again. Lots, well, maybe not Labor Day next year.
Maybe all summer because we got a boat now.
But we can do it all.
We had
and
relaxing on the water.
Donated to Crossfire.
Like,
it was pretty awesome.
Being able to do that and going and just relaxing on the water, that's the key to a good time.
I was talking to him. Huh? We were talking about it.
I said just going out on the water like that, it was like that's the key to having a good time.
Yeah, it was just really, it was.
A key?
It was the key to having
Yeah, it's funny because we went out on the lake and then there wasn't a key.
Was that a pun, Anthony?
Yeah.
It was
well, we got there and somebody had taken the keys out of the boat and went to Texas.
They were like,
if we can't go to the water, you're not going to the
water. You're not going either.
I'm just kidding.
We did.
Hey.
It was fine.
All right. Soon, Caleb? We're going to let you live.
Hey,
is
Caleb.
Too soon?
Did you hit a building with a box truck?
I don't know.
Truck?
I mean.
With a what?
I guess.
Did you hit the front of this building with a box truck?
I didn't.
Don't worry about it.
Don't
you're still
worry about
good.
It. You're good.
Because I know somebody who did that.
It was way better than the guy who ran under the awning with a box truck.
Hey, it all worked out.
I wanted
out.
To open the box
out.
Truck.
So we're going to turn to you guys now. That was a great time.
I can't
let's tell what's happening. We have a youth back to school bash.
When is that
happening tonight?
Yes, we do.
So what date? Let's give the date.
What's the date? September 7th, which is today. That's all you need to know.
Yeah. So for those who are watching live, everyone else know this just happened.
It'll
it was awesome.
Today.
So
yeah, we got some prizes that we're going to be giving out. We have gift cards to Dutch Rose.
Don't tell them all of them.
Well, I heard there was food, game, fun, videos, jousting, basketball, and prizes.
Videos. Mm-hmm. It says video games.
Video games, sorry.
But yeah, so all of that stuff, and we're going to have people competing against school, whoever's the most peppy is going to get a prize, like individually, and whatever school is, we're going to be looking at a couple things, whatever school has the biggest amount of participants, and also we're going to be looking at the peppiness that they have and that they bring.
Oh. Peppiness, I thought
like
you said
that.
Peppiness.
Well, further.
You scream like a girl.
And they're gonna earn free pizza with us at their school. Domino's Pizza. It's good pizza.
Domino's got great pizza.
Really
so
pizza.
Come and bring your friends. Teenagers, bring your friends. It's gonna be a great time. We're still gonna have our message, and that's just gonna be tacked on at the end for some extra fun and extra free prizes. So
gonna be good.
All right. So I also want to tell you of the back to church day,
Sunday,
September 18th, yep. And it's going to be a free breakfast, so come and have free breakfast that day, which we have every Sunday, but that'll be an extra special free breakfast.
Yeah, we're going to probably have like flavored creamer.
We have that.
Working hard.
We're gonna have something real good. I don't know.
Probably biscuits and gravy.
I really like those Biscoffs that they give you on the plane.
Full-on food other beyond that.
Let's just give them a cookie.
So
there'll donuts.
Be free breakfast.
Know, it'll be great.
Free full breakfast, and we are giving away 150
t-shirts.
Brand new, hot off the press, printed
Healing House shirts.
And they're going to be great. And we'll give 150 of them out and then destroy the screen so that that shirt will be the only shirt ever made.
I'm not doing that.
Yeah, that sounds nice.
I like those.
I need those.
We just made that up.
Yeah.
Doing that.
All right. We also, longer term out, we have our trunk or treat that's at the Eugene campus.
Yeah.
And we will be having our harvest party, and we've been doing it for years. We'll totally redo this whole church inside and some out. And we'll be having our party here. It'll be great. We just outreach to the community. We like to do that.
On October 14th and 15th, Friday night, all day Saturday, we are going to be having our annual fall women's conference. It's exciting. So that's just right around the corner. We're going to be doing it at our Eugene campus. So that's pretty awesome. We do so much at Springfield that we want to do some things and steer the ladies to that Eugene campus. So we're excited about it, and it's going to be a great, great time.
Also, know this, we have an Israel trip. Christy's still working on the dates.
We don't have it sealed in. It's not locked in.
And the Philippines trip, I've actually been asked to go and speak in the Philippines, so I'll be there in January. But then we'll be taking a team that will be going out to Negros. The plan right now is to be there the week before Easter, and so that would be our plan, is to take some people and be there in the Philippine Islands. For if you want to go, let us know. A lot of great things happening. Website, we try to keep updated as far in advance as possible, so we're getting a lot of the camps and different things back on the website, so you can plan your whole year, 2022 and coming up 2023. Yeah. All right, don't forget all the normal things that happen, our prayer service every week, our men's and women's Bible studies. There's small groups for the ladies now and for the men.
Lots of them.
There's Wednesday night. Tonight, I got a bunch of stuff cooking. You're cooking. Tell us a little bit of what you're doing to help out the police department with Lazarus, Anthony, on Thursday. And if maybe somebody wants to volunteer or help, that would work.
Lars donut delivery. Not really.
No, we're not.
That would be bad. Hopefully Bob's not watching this.
Oh, Bob's Donuts.
Ha. Bob's Donuts, ooh.
Yeah.
Chief of Police Bob Morris. Anyway, so we have an opportunity. We are partnering with a few other churches and community outreaches in Junction City, and the police department hosts a Burgers in the Park or Burgers with Bob once a year, and they have asked us if we would be interested in bringing Lazarus and a few people and preparing the food for them, and so we're going to do that. We're actually starting today, right now. And cooking until tomorrow night. 1,500 people, they're expected to attend, and then we also will get to do another event in Junction City for their 150th or 175th, a big anniversary event that the city's putting on. Mm-hmm. And about the same again. So plenty of chances to get involved and just come and volunteer and serve our community. And if you like that kind of stuff, and you like food service, let us know.
Yeah.
If you just like serving people.
Yeah.
All right. One last thing is we are making progress on our building payoff. We're asking you that if you'll mark any gift building gift, building fund, building payoff, everything extra will go towards that. We are trying to pay off either $185,000 to pay off our camp facility, or if we get some help, and if we can raise it, which seems impossible, but nothing is impossible
to God
or with God, is we would like to pay off this Springfield property, which is our most important building to pay off. The reason we need to pay it off is multiple. I encourage you to check the last update. Mm-hmm. Shares kind of the vision and the purpose behind that. But we do need to relieve of our monthly cost to that. The payment on the building is, or not the payment, the part we need is come up with $307,000. We're somewhere close to the $200,000 range. Mm-hmm. So,
is that possible?
It's possible with God, and when people are willing to say, you know what, I'm gonna buy into that, and I believe in what the church does. I got to tell you, this has nothing to do with the building payment, but it does, or paying it off. But when I came in, after having this big event on Sunday, seeing people, we definitely saw and planted a lot of seed. We watered a lot and we reaped a harvest. I mean, that was amazing. Mm-hmm. So all three of those things happened. And when we got off the last ride that I came in and it was late, it was, you know, close to 10 o'clock. We rolled in and I come walking in the building to, you know, make sure everything was shut down and get stuff out. I just got this overwhelming gratefulness for what God has already given us. He's given us so much. The properties that we have, the buildings that we have, the camps, that we can do so much, but it's a we. It's not the church is all of us. And we have so many tools, more tools than we can use. We had people line up in the coffee cart, but I have no one that, you know, I don't have enough people to run the coffee cart and the free breakfast and everything else we do to serve people and share the love of God. It's just more than we have. We need some of you to step up and say, man, I want to be a part. I'm willing to give a few hours a week and serve. Yeah. And, you know, our kids' church, our nursery, we need to start a Wednesday night kids' church. Mm-hmm. That is really important. A Wednesday night kids' church. We need to finish up our youth room. There's a lot there that we need to do, because space-wise, we need to make sure every space is full and being utilized completely.
We're outgrowing spaces.
We are. We definitely are, especially on Wednesday nights, which is really positive, because that Wednesday night is a real discipleship time for all ages. So where we're hurting is people who will do kids' church on Wednesday night. And not just everybody gets to do kids' church. We're pretty selective of who does. Yeah. So it's not easy to just say, oh, do kids'
I'll
church.
I'll babysit the kids.
Yeah, because it's not like that. We don't want to babysit them. We want to, although at this point, we probably would handle babysitting. We really want more than that.
Yeah.
Awesome. Good stuff. Feeding program's still happening. They're feeding this Thursday and next Thursday and the next Thursday. And if you need food, come noon to 4 any Thursday of the week, right here to the Springfield campus. Go through our new drive-through area and we'll load you up and make sure we can help take care of your family during these very difficult times. Mm-hmm. It's what the church should be doing. We do a lot of counseling, a lot of, you know, helping, a lot of working with families. And you know, just today, we had a very difficult case yesterday, two of them, where we needed to help some people who, one, have had their power shut off for 3 months. And, you know, as a church, that's what we do. We step in and try to help those things through our benevolence fund. If you have a benevolent need, go to our website. If you would like to give directly, 100% directly, not your tithes and offering, anything above that. If you'd like to help, you can give towards that. The money goes directly to families and hurting people who need Jesus, and they might need some help, assistance. Yeah. So a lot of great things. Thanks for joining with us today. Show the whole crowd. It's great to have you guys back. We can't wait to work you like dogs.
Yeah. Well, Colette.
We have one more event.
Hebrew means dog. So.
Go.
Go ahead.
I don't know what date it is.
It's the 29th. I don't know either. Yeah, that's why I'm trying to open
the
that.
The 29th of October, Elevation Nights is coming.
Oh, yes.
And our church has bought
a block of tickets.
So if you're interested in wanting to come and sit with Crossfire, we have a block of tickets. We are not, we're not overpricing selling them. We're selling them for what they cost us. And
we do need to sell them all.
We do need to sell them all.
And if you put them on your credit card, it's going to charge, we're going to up at 3%.
Yeah, it charges just the interest rate or the percentage rate. But I want to say, I don't have the exact number of the cost of them, but it's very reasonable. Well, and we have...
It's expensive, but...
Well, it's cheaper than you're going to buy them in real life right now for the same area. We bought them early enough that we got a reduced rate and we got a group rate. So if you're wanting to and you want to sit with a block of us, connect with us, you can go to our website.
Matthew Knight Arena.
MyCrossfire.com. You can click on that. I believe we have like in the neighborhood of like 20-something tickets left. So if you want to sit with a Crossfire block, we're going to be representing, and it's going to be great.
What, how many did you buy? 35? 40?
No, 40-something.
40-something, 40, 50 tickets. All right. So
God bless you. Have a fantastic rest of your day. One more thing.
On the 28th, to see you at the pool, where students all across the nation will come 1 hour before their first spell, and they're going to pray over their schools. So this is especially important for parents. We want the students, not just the leaders, but the students to be praying over their schools and to be going and boldly bringing Christ. And so if you're a parent of a teenager especially, be ready for this to help your teenager get there. 1 hour before the first spell, and that is on the 28th. If you want any more information, go to syatp.com, and they have all of it for you there.
All right. Also, or you can go to our website, and there should be a link on the youth section.
Yeah, just go to my Crossfire. You get everything there. So
there you go. Also, if you did not receive this in the mail this last month, that means we do not have your address. We'd love to have your address. This is the update. You can get it online, but we'd like to get you a physical copy in your hand. It also comes with a real handy dandy thing. You know what it is? Let me see if I can find one. I can't find one, of course. I ruined that. But somewhere, it comes with an envelope and a link. And so the envelope is a Crossfire. Oh, they're not here anymore. They got lost. Oh, there it is.
Woo! Oh, good.
That's Crossfire offering envelope. This is actually pretty important. Or you can go to our website, or you can download our app. But we really encourage you to be faithful to this ministry. We can do things for free. We can reach out to the community. We can't do it if people don't first give and say, hey, I believe in the way you help people that are hurting. I believe in the way that you reach out to people. You know, we were really careful not to charge for anything during this car show, because it wasn't a car show for us. It was for them. We did an actual car show. Mm-hmm. It was a motorcycle Sunday, and we had a motorcycle show.
It was a full-on car show.
It was.
It was cool.
But, and we didn't shove anything down anyone's throat. But what we did do is we built bridges with people, and we showed them the love of Jesus. Mm-hmm. And to do that, we could have charged. It could have been about money. Mm-hmm. We didn't want to make it about money. Everyone always says, well, you know, this is just about money. You're just trying to make money. We didn't make any money.
Nope.
We lost money.
Yeah.
And we lost money that was worth every penny, because we also found souls.
Yeah.
People who didn't know Christ, who came to Christ, people who are now going to be coming into our church. Even tonight, we got people coming that their exact words were, I've never went to church, but I heard what you had to say that day. Yeah. I never have been in church. Or I'm going to go home and get my family. I want them to be here today. This is awesome. I didn't know churches did this. Folks, we can't put a car show on every week. Mm-mm. But once in a while, we can do something to reach out to hurting and broken and unchurched people that need to know Christ. We all do, every one of us. And we're not ever hiding that. But we can have fun serving God.
Yeah.
It's okay to have fun.
Yeah.
I'm kind of, I wonder sometimes if the church for so many years have made it out to be this horrible thing. We ought to have fun.
Yeah.
I think it's because a lot of times church people are trying to put it on, and so it's a lot of work. But we need to sit back and have some fun too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We did that at the lake.
Church is fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Church is fun. Church people are fun. I'd rather be around people that love Jesus and you're not constantly on guard. They're not judging. They're not living in sin. You're not. I mean, what a great group of people to live with and support and be around and do life with.
Yeah.
So pretty awesome, and we appreciate all of you. Got anything that came in on any of our live streams here? If people commenting?
No, Alyssa put in the amount. It's like $61.50, $63.50 if you do a credit card for the Elevation Nights. Go to our website and get connected with that.
So,
other than that, we are good, I think.
I will tell you, what you can't see on here is, you know how we got our vans fixed again? You don't have vans anymore, because they have drilled out our gas tanks again and broke all of our way you can fill it through your hoses. Happened again this week. Guy came in, we watched him on camera, but it didn't catch him this time. Took a dump in the parking lot, shot up with heroin, and then stole our gas, and in process cost us about $3,000 by the time we repair all the vehicles and the gas tanks and, the filler spouts. So this has happened so many times. We now have better cameras. We now have better fencing. I'll tell you what, I really struggle with thieves. They need Jesus bad.
Yeah.
And so be praying for us. And it gets really old, this whole thing. But praise Jesus. Thank you for your support. Thank you for your help. And let's do some things that Jesus would have us do every day. Yeah. Let's grow and let's learn and let's develop as the body of Christ. That's what it's all about.
Yeah.
All right.
Awesome.
Amen.
Crossfire World Outreach Ministries is supported by faithful monthly contributions from viewers like you. Please take time today and make your tax-deductible gift to Crossfire World Outreach Ministries, 942 28th Street, Springfield, Oregon, 97477, 541-686-3473, or find us on the web at mycrossfire.com.